Remove the protective wrapping from the toothbrush. Put the wrapping next to your left foot. Open the toothpaste. Put the cap on top of the wrapping. Now put a generous amount of paste on the sterile bristles. People, you will brush your teeth in a rapid vertical motion for 1 minute. That's up and down for you rebel motherfuckers. Now, when I say stop, you turn to your right and you brush. Ready? Brush. You may notice a granular taste. That's pumice. Its purpose is to sear the teeth and allow the fluoride to penetrate. Gentlemen, in Vietnam, you will be confronted by many organisms in the food, water, air that are foreign to American bodies. Ringworm, impetigo, malaria, amoebic dysentery, and crotch rot. Has been found that proper dental hygiene is an important component in the maintaining of a healthy fighting man. What are you doing?
Come on, lighten up, bro.
I'm not your brother. Now, did I tell you to spit?
No, sir.
If you want to walk out of this fucking place, you will listen to people who know. You be an individual, and I'll be tagging your ugly, toothless face straight on its way to a long box with metal handles. Now, brush your teeth in a rapid vertical motion! Fruit.
All right, listen up. You people will not die on me in combat. You fucking new guys will do everything to prove me wrong. You walk on trails, kick cans, sleep on guard, smoke dope, and diddly bop through the bush like you were back on the block. Or in guard at night, you write letters, play with your organ, and think of your girl back home. Forget her. Some hairhead has her on her back right now and is telling her to fuck for peace. This is hard. Foolish will think of him as Gook, Slope, Slant, or Dink. He is your enemy. He came over on the Chu Hoi program, and he'll go back out there after he fattens up on sea rations, and he will be hunting your young asses in the Yashau Valley. Now forget about this Viet Cong shit. What you encounter out there is hardcore NVA, North Vietnamese, motivated, highly trained, and well equipped. If you meet Han or his cousins, you will give him respect and refer to those little bastards as Nathaniel Victor. Meet him twice and survive, you will call him Mr. Nathaniel Victor. People, I am tired of filling body bags with your dumb fucking mistakes. You think this funny? Alphabet?
Languilli.
Han is closing in on your position. It's night. Look at me! I'm gonna save your life and you're gonna save mine. It's night. It's raining. While you're thinking about peace, love, and whether or not we should be in Vietnam, Han is gonna cut your fucking throat. And you're sleeping.
No, Sergeant.
You've been humping the boonies for months. You're tired. It's your turn to sleep. You're allowed to sleep. What do you think Han is gonna do? Is he gonna wake up Alphabet and smile? And talk about women? Mr. Nathaniel Victor gets his rocks off watching you die. Now, some of you think you have problems because you're against the war. You demonstrated in school, you wear peace symbols on your steel, and you have attitudes. I'm an orphan. My brother's queer. The city of Chicago got the clap from my sister. Mom drinks. Dad coughs blood. I have ringworm, immersion foot, the incurable crud, and the draft ruined my chances of being a brain surgeon. People, you have no problem. Except me. And him.